You know what women want most of all?
More.
More.
Exactly. Yeah.
Whatever it is they want.
More. It's time to join the movement. GYBB. Get your balls back.
They don't understand. I'm giving you the best of me so that I can fuck you. But yeah. Once that's over, the contract is over.
All right.
Wrong. Everything your mama said, wrong.
Fuck that bitch too. But this is some stuff I pulled out of the Bible. Now, I don't believe in the Bible. I don't.
And then the Lord said,
Timothy 2:11-15, let a woman learn quietly with all submissiveness. Shut your mouth.
Oh, shit. We are in the pimp cup. It's about to go down. And I am excited.
Oh, nice.
Yeah,
nice.
Yeah.
Me too.
Because this today,
right.
This day,
right,
is a special show.
Wow, okay.
Now, I've said that 180 times before, but this time
different.
I mean it.
Okay.
Right?
All right.
I mean, I meant it before, but I mean it now.
You mean it even more now than you meant it before.
GYBB, get your balls back. BABB, be a better bitch. WWDD, what would Dante do? The sexual revolution is being podcasted, and I am excited.
Oh.
This guy I got on the show today, I'm going to get into that in a minute. But first of all, we got to shout out to Marek, because that bitch had to leave. She had to work again. So it ain't my fault, people. Text that bitch and tell her, come home.
Yeah.
Stop playing. Acting like you got a career.
Yeah.
This show is your career, bitch. Stop playing.
Stop trying to be somebody.
Yeah, like what the fuck? She got all self-esteem now. Got a boyfriend in love. What the fuck?
Self-esteem.
When did she get self-esteem? Harry, how you doing? You good?
I am good. You know, despite it all, trying to keep those gators down.
It is difficult.
Having a tough time doing it.
It is difficult. But they say pimping ain't easy, but it gets easier with time. And how is my son, huh?
I'm doing well, man.
That's good.
Doing pretty good.
A little
really
hungry
good? Still?
Yeah, a little hungry. You're always hungry, so whatever.
You know, it's just...
Any new bitch problems that we can talk?
No, they're behaving. Doing quite well.
They are behaving. Okay. That's good.
Doing
That's
quite
good.
Well.
Let me let you know, it's not going to last.
And that never.
It's never going to last.
The calm before the storm. Just
yeah, that's it. It's not going to last.
I'm aware of this. I'm ready.
So you know that. Here's the killer. This guy I'm about to bring to you. I would consider him a friend. We kind of started comedy the first time. One of few dudes I think is funny.
Absolutely. It's one of my personal favorites, and yeah. I've said this many
times. Yeah, you
times.
Have said that even before you knew he was coming on the show.
Absolutely.
I've heard you say that on the show. This dude, funny
comedians.
Dude. Comedy Central, all kinds of
I believe
shit.
Conan, right?
Conan, you got a Conan?
No, it was not on Conan.
What did you have?
You had another one.
I know I've seen you on TV with some shit.
I was on like I was on Best Week Ever for
Best
a while.
Best Week Ever. Oh, yes.
Nice.
Yes.
The first
season.
Genesis.
Yeah.
The good when it was good.
When it was good before you they got rid of you.
Before
now
it became
it's,
the worst week ever.
Now it stinks.
Well, I was on it at the end. I was on it like the last year it was on.
Right.
But I wasn't on every episode. I was on it like intermittently. And
funny
then,
funny dude, give it up for Tom McCaffrey.
Okay, you're like enough of that.
I wanted to get your name out there.
Yeah.
So it wasn't funny and you got on it and it got funny.
Well, no, I think it was you know, it was on for a while. Like, I knew about it. And
right.
then I was on it at the way end where, I don't know if you remember this, it was on, and then they changed the format.
Right.
Like, they were, they were trying to compete with, what's that, like, that Joel McHale show?
Oh,
the Soup.
Yeah, the Soup.
Right. So they made it, instead of having, like, a cast of people, they had, like, Paul F. Tompkins be the host.
Oh.
And then they would have, like...
And that went to shit from there.
Well, it was really funny, because I was on it the way... And, I like, a couple of the producers really liked me.
Uh-huh.
And I remember I came in, I kept hearing that they were changing format.
Right.
And I was one of the last people in. And, like, you know, I had big people. Like, Nick Kroll was, like, on it. And, like... So...
Paul Scheer.
Yeah. And, like, Judah Friedlander. And so, like... I came in one of the last days to tape, and they were like, "Hey, well, you know, we're changing the format, but like, we think like we're gonna bring people on still, like, just to do like segments, and you know, we'll have you probably do that." And then I was like, "Yeah, all right." And then I went in the last day to tape my, you know, the old format.
Yeah, yeah.
And that producer, like, just kind of was like, hey, and then, like, walked away. So, I was like, oh, I'm clearly not on the show anymore. But I didn't think I would
be. Right.
But then the new format bombed, and then the show got canceled. And then they brought it on, like,
and good
a year
for them,
because
they should have never fucking got rid of Tom McCaffrey. They should have kept him on the show.
I was the glue.
Because he's the glue that stuck it together. That's what it was. The rest of the motherfuckers ain't got shit on Tom McCaffrey.
Oh, no.
That's it.
That was their slogan for that show for a while.
That's why it didn't do so well. They're like, you know, we should put this guy on TV first before we start pushing that slogan.
Right.
Yeah, this was crazy. Tom, how long you been doing comedy stuff?
I think almost 15 years ago.
Yeah, so we started around the same time.
Yeah.
I'm 15 and going on 16.
Like, I think I met you in like 2002. I was in LA for like 2 years.
Okay.
And then I moved back here in 2002.
Yeah.
And then me and you and DeRosa did a road gig in
out in the Hamptons. We had a ball. It was a kind of shitty gig, but I mean it was good for then.
I actually thought it was good. It paid and it was
it paid and it we showed Hamptons. Up and we had it was Hamptons and we
I think I did my first ever road gig with Tom McCaffrey, not as glamorous if you remember this. Was
Staten Island?
It wasn't Staten Island. Kidding. It was on Long Island.
Oh, was
but
it?
But it was like 3 hours into Long Island and it was at some bar or something. All
right,
here's the story.
That sounds about right.
We drove for, like, this guy named Sean Anamazalis. I don't know. He's probably not doing comedy anymore.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so, was that the one where they, like, weren't going to pay us?
I don't remember getting paid for it. I think I did get paid for it, but it was a hellish gig. We drive out all the way, like, 3 hours into Long Island.
Uh-huh.
We pull up to this bar on a Friday night. A guy, the most Guido guy I've ever seen, pulls up to the bar in, like, a white Cadillac. And he gets out. He's, like, chewing gum in a muscle tee. He's like, what's going on here tonight? And we go, one of the guys goes, stand up.
You told me the story.
One of the guys goes, stand up comedy. And he kind of shakes his head, like thinking about it. And then he immediately gets in his car, slams the door, and peels out of the parking lot.
Yeah, he had the right idea.
I should have known then.
You knew it was going to be shit.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Yeah, that was one of the first gigs I ever did.
A lot of shit gigs that coming up. I mean, me and Tom came up together.
Well, I do remember that Hamptons gig, though. Yeah. We got there at like 8, and they were like, all right, the show's not starting till 11.
Yeah, it was fucking
so
crazy.
But they had like, I think they gave us free drinks.
Yeah, we drank for free.
And I do remember there were a lot of hot chicks there. I do remember that.
I used to do this gig out in the Hamptons every Monday or Tuesday. And it was like we'd just get in the car and drive out to the fucking Hamptons. And I would do a show. It was like a cool gig for a Monday or Tuesday. Like,
it was great. I used to like
and
all
the pay was
up,
pretty good. It was like 100 and something.
I think it paid like 100, 150. Yeah. I mean, I think I did like 15 minutes. Yeah. The crowd was like cool.
Yeah. It was real cool.
Well, especially when you first start out any gig, is it like an exciting gig? Yeah, so one day you get paid.
Yeah, but
like,
you know what? Like, I never really had that problem like getting paid. I always
really
said,
you didn't have a problem
getting
paid.
You look like you
wouldn't
have a problem getting paid.
It's funny that Dante apparently
they're like, here's $100. You're like, I didn't even do a show.
I just did my version of Mia Isabella.
Right, yeah.
And it's so weird. Nobody ever fucking didn't pay me.
It's like,
it's a little bubble.
Maybe, I don't know. That guy always pays me extra. I don't know.
maybe because my hands look like I'm wearing boxing gloves, right?
Yeah.
my big fucking tennis racket mitts. So, yeah, but it was like, I would always, like, if I got a road gig and you did a road, I made sure dudes got paid. We always got top dollar. Otherwise, I wouldn't do it.
Mm, right.
I just wouldn't do a shit. I'd be like, nah, I wouldn't be coming out there for that. It was like a 4-hour ride. Like, on, you know, like we had to leave like during rush hour. So we're on the LIE for 3 or 4 hours and then we'd stop at the diner or something.
I remember I remember you and DeRosa got into a fight. That's one thing I remember.
Yeah.
About,
you know,
what?
Oh,
I don't remember. But I just remember like 10 minutes in, you guys started screaming at each other.
Well,
I didn't really, I mean, I met you. We didn't know it. And like, I kind of knew Joe and I'm in the back seat. And you guys, well, yeah, you fucking.
Here's
me.
Why.
And then I think you were like, Tom, isn't he being a dick? And I'm like, I don't know what's going on.
What it was, Joe, I mean, and I love Joe. Love Joe to death. I mean, that's probably why it bothered me. Joe just called me up and he goes, yeah, buddy, I don't know. I figured you wanted to help me move my furniture out of it. And I'm like, dude, I have leather seats in my Tahoes. I have a brand. Why would I want to move your fucking seats?
Right.
And he was like, well, we're friends. I'm going. Not really.
We're not that level.
You know what? Even less so right now.
Right. And I just couldn't believe that he just thought it was so obvious. But I mean, I love Joe. It's my
buddy.
He's
just a big guy, though. It's not anything other than like.
Yeah, let's move. I want to move your furniture.
It's
nobody.
The dumbest shit ever. People really do that. They see you like, oh, you look like you got muscles. Help me move a car.
Yeah, oh, yeah,
like,
you must get that all the time.
Dumbest things.
Like, having
you
a,
move
having
my
muscles.
Car?
Yeah, move my car. Help me move. I need a couch. I got to move a couch. Like, right, no, right. Motherfucker.
Having muscles is like owning a van. Like, you're going to get a lot of requests to go to the
so
airport.
Weird. It's fuck.
Yeah, do you get, like, do you, would you get that a lot in bars and stuff? People just try and start fights with you because they're like, oh, this guy thinks he's tough?
No. They kind of know I'm tough.
Like, just, okay. I just, the weird part is MMA fighters and boxers say they get that shit all the time.
But I'm kind of personal. You know, I'm a personal dude, and I think I know how to throw the energy around. You know what I mean? Like, I bounced for years, and...
Did you ever... I mean, you probably had to throw a lot of people out, right?
Yeah, I mean, I used to fight. I mean, I'd knock a dude in the mouth, unhinge a jaw, too, knock a couple teeth out. I mean, come on, haven't we all... Huh?
Yeah, no.
Tom?
Yeah, yeah.
Come on.
On my way up here.
But I mean, I think there's a you can give off an energy that just go he's not really the dude that it's funny. I remember going to Patrice's barbecue and I'm in the barbecue and I'm kind of like the biggest and kind of the toughest dude there, right?
Probably among the comedians.
Yeah, amongst the comedians.
Yeah, you take that.
And little then, Jim Norton.
Unless Joe Rogan decides to make a cameo, I think it's all yours.
And then Keith or Tom, if Tom walks in.
Yeah.
Then this Keith brings this motherfucker from Philly. Keith Robinson brings this guy from Philly, right? And soon as he walked in the backyard, I was like, there's a disturbance in the force. There's somebody who clearly has a body or two. I could just feel that this dude
had that
was,
Kill Bill.
Yeah. And I kind of...
It's just like a bad energy?
Yeah. It wasn't a bad energy. It's just like you could just tell people that have hurt other people. I don't know.
You had like teardrop tattoos?
No, yeah. It was like when he walked in.
Yeah, no, I know.
Keith said, oh, this is my boy from South Philly, blah, blah. I shook his hand and I was like, And he kind of looked at me and was like,
Yeah.
Right? And I was like, oh, good. And then he was polite. Like, good to meet you, da 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 da. And then it was just like...
It's probably like
this
when a Highlander runs into another Highlander.
Probably, yeah.
And I was like, and he was really cool. And I said, I just pulled Keith. I said, Keith, I want you to know something. I'm the only tough motherfucker here. Stop bringing your goofy jail friends from Philly. And then he was like, yeah, how'd you know he was from jail? I was like, you could tell. And he was really polite and just nice, but you could just feel that this motherfucker didn't take no shit. And maybe that he might have had a body or two. So, just me. Maybe it's my sixth sense.
Did you guys fight?
No, he was just cool. Just he was really cool.
I got another quick road story before I forget that I had with Dante. This was years ago. The first time I ever did anything with Dante.
The Mike D story?
No. This was years before that.
Okay.
There was some road story where, I get into his car, and I kind of know Dante a little bit from hanging out at the Boston Comedy Club. This is the first time we're working together. He's like, nah, come in my Jeep, blah, blah, blah. We'll go together.
Right.
He goes, hey, man, I got to make a phone call or whatever. So he calls up, hey, baby, what's going on? Yeah, I'm going up to this gig. Yeah, we're going up to perform at this thing or whatever. Or I'll call you later tonight. Click. Hey, baby, what's going on? I got to... Yeah, no, we're going up to this thing. Yeah. Oh, I know. I love you, too. Bye. Hey, baby, what's going on?
Oh,
yeah, no, we're going up
checks.
To this thing. Seven in a row.
Really?
And every once in a while, there'd be some intermittent, like, how's your cold doing? You know, just something to make it personal. This was when he was really in his hoe days.
So what, were you just like... You would just be dating, like, HX? That sounds like a nightmare.
Yeah, it is. But you get used to it.
You gotta love it, I think, the way Dante does.
Yeah,
that's
do.
The thing.
I
you
really
act like,
do.
Eh, it's normal. You enjoy the challenge and the thrill of it.
I really do love women, man. I love all
I mean,
of
I,
them.
I mean, yeah, but dating them is really hard.
Yeah, it's...
You know,
I am not,
Tom,
like, I have not figured
it
out.
You have summed up everything.
Here's what's crazy, though.
Feel.
This is fucking,
just
this was the
hard.
Thing. Fucking Tom.
I just can't do
Tom's
it.
Ex-girl might have been one of the hottest chicks in comedy ever. She was ran the comics. She ran comics, yes?
Oh, that. I was like, which one are you talking about?
Okay, that
so
one,
many hot ones.
Yeah, that one was like, we were like, fuck, smoking hot Asian chick.
Yeah, she was all right.
She was fucking hot, you know. She was hot. And
I can't, I'm not good at... dealing, especially as I get older, I just can't deal with
that. Is it that you can or you just don't want to?
You don't have the ability.
I think it's like
one and the same, no?
Yeah. I just don't know that I'm so set in my ways that I'm just kind of like,
I don't want to deal with this.
I just can't deal with it as much as I could. And then it depends on the woman. And then sometimes certain women become like, they become like your job.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, oh,
yeah.
Literally.
Absolutely.
No, it's
absolutely.
All, yeah, it's a part time.
And it's
job.
Just like, and you don't want to, you know, when you start dealing with so much of your life is around this.
Yeah.
It's just like, this isn't worth it to
this
me.
This is right. Bitches are like math, though.
Oh, really? In what sense?
Because if you're good at math, you like math. You know what I mean? If you're good at doing math, you're like, man, math is amazing.
I'm pretty good. I'm good at math.
Yeah. Do you like math, though?
I don't know that I like it. I mean, in school, I was like really, I was good at it. I liked
but
it.
But did you like math? I mean, in school, did you
but
like?
But no, it's not like math, because math is very like this and this. You get a very objective
no,
answer.
No, I don't mean like that.
Women
I mean,
is like this and this, and then I don't know what the fuck
some random
is going on.
No, it's
answer.
Really, it is. You just don't, you don't know how to plug it in the equation. That's right. You haven't simplified for X yet. And
one plus two equals three.
Once you simplify for X, then it's easy. You just got to balance the equation.
I will say I've gotten better. Like, I go through this all the time where I get in these situations with dealing with women where I'm just kind of like, I don't want to deal with them anymore. Uh-huh. And like, I'm at that point now where I'm just kind of like, I, you know, because I'm older now.
Yeah.
And like, I used to, you know, like women will blow me off now.
Right.
And I used to be like, oh my God, what's going on? And like, I think that's where guys run into problems, where they keep chasing, and I'm just like, I don't chase
because they
women.
Find you. They find you less attractive when you're chasing them.
Also, because you guys don't realize. I mean, all day, especially with texting now, just women are just getting bombarded
yeah.
with texts.
Right.
If they're at all decent looking, all day, that's what they're getting. It's such a different. The world is such a different place.
Right, right.
Obviously. If you're like a hot woman, you know what I mean?
Well,
even if you're not that hot.
Even if you're not that hot, you're still getting those. But I think that's the thing. It's funny when I hear guys talk about how they just, it's like, it's so not simple. And it, to me, it's really, really simple. But it's simple for me because I studied it and I'm good at it. I'm good at it and it's like.
Well, I think dating them in a long like
no, just all
them.
Aspects of it. I guess,
I don't know. I always get it. Always becomes miserable for me.
I think it can become miserable, but I think what happens is usually it becomes miserable. Well, this is an interesting thing because usually it becomes miserable because you operate with women the same way if you were a dude dealing with a relationship with a friend with a dude. You know what I mean? Like the same.
I usually ask my dude friends to blow me.
No, not usually, but once in a while.
Yeah.
Come on,
hey,
I mean,
it's Labor Day. We're both off from work.
What I'm saying is, like, for instance,
exactly.
one of the things that I say is like I had a friend of mine that I was with him and I knocked the dude out. Some guy did some shit and I knocked the dude out. And so, like, if I'm with you, Tom, and some guy says something to you and I knock the door, we are friends forever.
Right.
When I call you to move, like Joe DeRosa did, to move the couch, you have to come.
Okay.
Even if I call you 7 years from now, Tom, I'm in a bind. I know I haven't spoke to you in a while, but... I don't even have to say I knocked the dude out from you. You already hold that as, it was the dude, you knocked the fucking dude out from me. And women are like, you could have given them a kidney today and tomorrow she's going, I don't know what the fuck is wrong with you. I just don't see what the fuck, it's there's no bank. Like, they don't have a bank of shit that you can
are worse than others. Some of them, I have dated women in the past where they're, you can never do enough for them. You'll do so many, because that's the worst feeling when you do a lot for them and you feel like you're putting yourself out and then the next day you don't
it's
do
nothing.
One thing
right.
they want and they're like, fuck you.
Right,
and it's like, that's a bad, well, I mean, it's a red flag now.
Sure.
Immediately. I'm much better now as I get older seeing the red,
but
paying
they
attention
all do
to the red
that.
Flags.
I think they all
I know,
do that.
But there's
some a degree.
Are a lot worse.
There's a degree.
Yeah.
But, one of the things we say on Beige Phillip is anytime you do anything for a woman more than three times is no longer a favor, it's an obligation. On the third time you do it, it's what you should do. And I find that to be the case even with really considerate girls or girls who are a lot more considerate and not as fucking crazy. But after the third time, it just becomes what you're supposed to do. They take it for granted. Mm. And this is why we say it's funny because you say because it just doesn't become fun. But you have to put your friend your happiness first above the woman's happiness because your happiness includes her happiness.
Right.
Like you can't be with a chick and she's just moping around and she's unhappy and then you're still happy.
Because, that doesn't happen.
Because that's right, because it's
but I'm really happy. Oh, you're really in a shitty mood all the time. This
right,
is great.
Right. It's almost like because we part of our manhood is attached to our ability to make our women happy and to keep them and do things for them and to provide and all those things. I mean, we like doing that, especially when we're doing that for somebody who appreciates it. The problem is we do that even when it's not appreciated. There's so much that we just consistently do and do and do and do and don't even take credit for it. And then when you do take credit for it, then they're like, oh, is that what it is? It's tit for tat. Yeah, bitch, it is tit for tat. Absolutely. Fucking do something. Or If I pay the bill, I take you out, I have a movie, I feed you, then when I say this all the time, when I leave my dirty drawers on the floor, shut the fuck up and pick them up. I don't want to hear about how I left it on there. If I left the microwave open, close the fucking microwave. Don't tell me I left it because I don't want to hear it.
I mean, I'm very like, yeah, choose your battles. When it becomes everything, like just everything that happens is a thing.
Yeah.
I'm just like, come on, dude. Like, do you really want to like just all day... I'm going to do things.
Right, right.
You know, I'm sorry.
Now, what is the response to that? Because that's a really reasonable, that doesn't work at all.
It sounds like when you said he treats, you're in a relationship with a woman the same way you expect to take, you know, the expectation you have
right,
with a guy.
Right,
the first thing he said was, come on, dude. So it's like, it shows right there. Yeah, like,
come on, dude. I mean, we cool.
I mean, I know. I guess I think that's the problem I run into in a lot of relationships. I'm very, because I think I am very
reasonable
and yeah. I dissect, like when you're dealing with women, you can dissect it into the most reasonable way. The argument
you can
and be right,
right,
and but they're still like it doesn't matter. Like they'll be like one girl literally was like, "I'm a girl, but I'm a girl."
Oh yeah, yeah.
And I was like, so
that's the most logical answer I've ever heard from a woman.
Well, it actually is.
Yeah, I'm a girl.
I'm a girl, which means I do stupid shit that don't make sense, and it's okay.
But
now
it's based on their emotional state at the time.
Absolutely,
correct.
Absolutely, yeah. It's based, but that's why you all you have to do is not. Dismiss just to dismiss it. Yeah. I just stupid. Mm-hmm. I'm not.
So I guess I have to find like kind of a medium between. I mean, and it depends on the girl. I mean, some girls. Yeah, I know you're gonna have those issues, no matter what.
Sure.
But there are some that I think are able to choose their battles better.
Well, here's the thing with that too. It's funny how you go. Well, I'm gonna do stuff like how, like really. Here's why. When you say, I break it down and I question myself and I'm a pretty reasonable person, right? What is the chances of you actually being unreasonable? I mean, you know what I'm saying? When you just in general, like
right.
If you say I'm a reasonable person, what you're in that declarative statement says. Look, I'm a guy who, look, I'm not perfect. I'm not always going to do the things, but in no shape or form am I intention malicious. Maybe I don't see it. We're brought up different households. We're different, and that could be an issue. But am I really doing something to hurt you where you feel as though it was malicious or out of place where I need to make a big stink about this? That's what you're saying. So simply by making that declarative statement, is anything you do really wrong? Do you know what I'm saying? Is it wrong or is it just... Okay, we just don't really agree with this, or I don't really care about the same shit that you care about, and I understand that you may care more about this particular issue, and it's important to you, but it's really not important to me. And okay, we can deal with it in that way, but I still don't really give a fuck.
I mean, I'm talking about things like once you get to the point where you're just every little thing like. You left this can here,
right.
And I want it here. Like when it becomes right. Every little thing, or like you know, you brush your teeth, and like when you spit in the sink, like some food was on the side after you. You know,
right,
I'm like, dude, like Well, then just turn the sink, like,
turn the water on. Wash it,
and
down.
Now we're in a fight for 3 days.
Right. Now, but here's the
That's
thing.
What I mean. I mean, like, right. What do you then it go back to the guy to who point. Fucked your friend? You know what I mean? Like, that's what, you know, it's just kind of like.
Are we talking about me?
Yeah,
shot at me?
Yeah, exactly. No, I'm just talking about, you know, you hear stories about these guys who, like,
right.
would get their, would fuck their friend, or, like, you know, would, like, I don't know, like, they. Their appendix would break and they would, like, dump them in the street, you know? And I'm like, well, then go back to that guy. Like, my thing is, like, I didn't...
I got food in the sink.
Go back to your fucking heroin addict boyfriend.
Yeah, you left your sock on the floor.
Who fucking just keeps doing and beats you.
Right, yeah, yeah.
Right, Harry?
Fucking dude. I'm not speaking from any personal experience.
But that's the thing. If you're dating a woman who kind of has... those bad experiences and has maybe not the best self-worth
but
or
it's
self-esteem.
Never, it's whatever. See, the thing is, it has nothing to do with you. It's just to the level that you're at. So if you beat your girlfriend, the worst thing she says, the fucking guy beats me every day. It's terrible.
Right.
If you don't beat her, if you yell at her, she goes, well, he doesn't beat me, but he's verbally abusive. He's terrible.
Right.
If you don't do either of that, he leaves his sneakers on the floor. He's fucking terrible.
He's really disrespectful.
He doesn't pay attention to me.
He doesn't pay attention to
me. He doesn't fight. Does he fight with you? No, but he just ignores me all the
time. Right. No matter what
situation.
He's not like he was the first week we dated. Right. It's like, right. When everything was lying.
Right, right.
Like,
we were both facades.
No, but it's like.
Don't act like
you
didn't lie too.
Like, I don't, like, you weren't blowing me. You're not blowing me every date now. I don't.
Kurt Metzger used to have his. That's what it is. We're settling. That's why you call it settle down.
Yeah.
Because I don't. You're not the ideal bitch for me. I just. You're what I could get right now.
Right.
Yeah.
And we make an agreement that we'll both just kind of settle for. We'll settle for each other. That's why we.
Because guess what? If something better rolled around, you take it.
Right.
There's no contract. You're out.
That's it. And women have integrity amnesia. So the minute that they don't feel that way, it's they dump you with extreme prejudice. So but it's funny because I talk to guys all the time. It's like, I'm really, you know, I mean, I'm not really into this chick, but I'm with her and I just feel like it would really hurt her. You get guys who, it's like for guys to be supposed to be such dogs and so have no feelings, they will stick with a chick when they don't want to stick with her. They will put up with her shit and just, you know what I mean?
Shout out to my dad, by the way. Shout out to my dad. He's not there anymore, but he was there for a while.
A long time. I did an interview with this dude, and he goes, and I was on Sirius Radio, and the guy goes, yeah, my girl, she is crazy. You know, she always got to make her point and this, that, and the other. And I go, but you put up with it. And he goes, I did not. We're not together now. I go, how long were you dating? 4 years. So you put up with for four fucking years. 4 years. So it's...
Even if you held strong, there's no way you held. Nobody's out of it, you know. Maybe you got a good year and a half there.
Yeah, but you didn't hold it together for
right.
You. But was so it's funny because this is something that I've been thinking about just recently. I say that you have to be unaffected by the nonsense. I mean, I think you have to kind of if you're a reasonable person, you go, am I being reasonable, fair, and firm? Am I being reasonable about what I'm asking of this person? Am I being firm about what my boundaries are? Am I being fair at is what her response to this fair? And I think if you go through that checklist and you're not and there's none of the answers to that is no, I go, then I think you can dismiss. I've just dismissed that kind of behavior. You know what I mean? Like, I think here's what I find is interesting. Women find you more attractive when you do that.
Yeah.
When you don't get caught up and have these, like when you're not going, dude, come on, like this is
right.
This is a
well,
thing.
The other thing too is that they will. A lot of that is like testing you, what
sure.
they can get away
absolutely.
With.
Absolutely.
So it's weird because being like fuck, like not fuck you, but being like. This is ridiculous and bullshit and
right.
kind of standing up for yourself is what they want.
Sure, sure.
But at the same time, it's like, why do you want, like, why do you
well,
want
well, he is
trying
to
make sense of
that's,
it.
That's
what, I know, I know. I have a very analytical.
That's the problem.
Here's
well, go ahead.
The thing, isn't it? Your thing is, at any point, a woman's always testing you subconsciously.
Right.
She's always testing you.
Right.
So it's not as if that's what they want. It's not as if a woman
it
goes,
really
I want to fight with this fucking guy all the
right.
time. But those are the tests. Like,
it's her weird they, yeah, go ahead, I'm sorry.
Her complaining about that food or scraps on whatever that you've left some food after you brush your teeth, that's really about like, I'm trying to test you to see how strong, how much bullshit are you going to put up with?
Right.
And that's what it is.
Right. And if you pass, then she's more attracted to you. And if you fail, she's less attracted to you.
Right. That's what also gets tiring about relationships. Right. Just sure, the constant testing.
Sure. Sure. But
you know, like, I'm just like, I don't want, and I, yeah, I don't think that they're conscious of it. No, and I, and that's right. another thing about what I feel like they think they know what they want, but they don't really want what they think they want.
They don't know what they want, period. That's really what the thing, I mean.
They think they do, but they don't.
But they don't. They have no idea. And, yeah. you know, we say this all the time. You don't know what you like. Your pussy does. It's when your pussy gets wet, that's how you know you like
it.
It's
such a hard one to get through.
Is that Shakespeare?
Feminists just hate that.
Well, they hate it because I'm because I say it on harshly. I say it harshly to that point. Because they take it as, oh, you don't think I'm mature enough to know what I'm... No, bitch, you don't. You don't know what the fuck you want. Most of the time when you're dealing with a woman, it's a multiple choice. It is for me to set up several multiple choice and for you to pick A, B, and C because you don't know how to fucking find your own happiness.
Yeah.
And
it's
that's
all multiple choice and all the answers are wrong.
I'm going to take D, none of the above. Right? So...
And that,
but what's interesting is that the fact that when you know women consistently go, I am this cognitive being. I can speak for myself. I know what I want. And no, you can't. You can't. You have no idea because you have this emotion that you're trying not to acknowledge. That makes no sense at all. And here it is. You're trying to deal with it from a reasonable, common right. sense point of view. And it none of it is reasonable.
I'm in law school right now.
Right. Right.
Oddly enough. Wow. Right. Wow. And I've wanted to do that for years, and now that I'm in it, it really makes sense, my behavior in relationships, because now all I'm doing all day is learning these arguments that I've kind of always had in my head.
Okay.
And so when you break it down in terms of like what's written down in law, and uh-huh. you have to apply it to that, that's what I was always doing in relationships. Like, I'd be like, no, but this is thing that was supposed to happen, and this is what I did, and you're mad that I did the thing,
right?
But they don't care. Like, that's what the whole answer
it's,
of like,
I feel,
but I'm a woman, and that's you're right. That's almost honest. Like, she was like, well, I'm a woman, what do you want? And like, I was like, okay, that's actually a good argument,
right? Right, right,
that's a fair argument.
It's like the insanity defense,
right? Right, sure, sure. I feel like
no, I didn't
when
mean
you...
that they're insane. I just
no, I do, yeah. They're, in, oh, okay. they're fucking nuts.
I meant that as a
that's,
joke.
You're in a safe place here, they're fucking nuts.
I mean, I didn't say insanity specifically. I just meant that.
Yeah, I'm going with insanity.
Okay, okay,
I'm going with that. I'm going with that. Absolutely. And I have these scars to prove it.
Right.
So it's what right. So you're trying to deal with it from a logical point of view is what you would do with another guy. Like, oh, you have a problem, and it's almost like when me and Joe were having a fight. Like, Tom, is this reasonable? What he's at, you know, and you're going, I wasn't listening. But had you have been listening, you would have been like, well, if I was in your position and he said this. That thing
well, you
is
did
a little
fuck his mom.
Right. So you could throw the
you're saying that was perfectly reasonable.
Right, that was you go
that was
is that reasonable? But when you
no,
when
that guys argue like that where they just get it. That's the problem with women a lot is
it's not
they never talk about. I mean, it's all the cliches like I'm fine. I don't want to talk about it. You're not really fine.
But even when they talk about it, they're not talking about it. They're talking about
the,
something
the
else.
Feelings.
Well, they talk
it's
about
feel.
The toilet seat, and right, they right. really are mad about yeah. you looked at a girl. You know what I mean? It's like, it's insane. Like, let's just put this out. Being single right now is I haven't really been single for a while, and like because I was just in relationship after relationship, and now I'm just kind of like it's sort of cool. Like, I mean, I'm getting comfortable with it.
Now, are you hooking up or no?
I mean, you know, I mean a little bit, but I'm really, really busy right now.
Right,
I kind of don't
law school. And
yeah,
shit.
And I mean, I kind of don't want to, because, like I said, once you get caught up in that, that become even you know, trying to meet women, it's just that takes up so much time, and then like, it's hard for me to meet women and not drink. You know, like I can't really hang out with women and not drink.
I don't drink at all, and
you know,
that's
no.
You know.
Yeah, but
you know,
man,
I just
why
I
say
can't.
Like, is it why is it just that.
I just
looser
I'm just
that
used
way.
To it. Oh, yeah, okay. It loosens me up. It seems like a very like.
Well, it's like if I'm out, I'm out. You know what I mean? If we're out hanging out, then we're out hanging out.
And it seems like a thing to do, like when you meet them, like are like, hey, let's
hey,
do this.
Drink?
Get a drink. It's the easiest sort of way. Let's go get a
but
drink.
It's weird because I tweeted this out the other day. It's really difficult not to put up with your chick's bullshit. Even though I know, like, I am the king of not putting up with nobody, but I still fall into these. Throughout my life, I fell into these traps. Mm-hmm. You know, a text about this, and what did you mean by that? And then you got me. Now I'm in an argument about something, and I'm arguing in a reasonable way.
But
and
you're still arguing,
and I'm still and I'm caught up. When I think you have to learn how to, like I say this on the show all the time. You have to be strong enough a man to protect yourself from her crazy. You also have to be strong enough to protect herself from her crazy. And you have to be strong enough to protect your relationship from her crazy, because she will fuck it all up and then blame it on you because you weren't strong enough to keep her from fucking scorching the earth. Mm-hmm. So it's saying things that that she knows might, well, not even, she just feels like this is the thing to say, and then it's, and you can't take it back, and it destroys trust or does this. I mean, how many times? I mean, I'm a real fucking duality. Like, I will watch a documentary on the Federal Reserve and then watch Maury Povich right afterwards, yeah. Right? Like, I will do ratchet TV and then some really heavy documentary. And what I find is you when you watch Maury Povich, the chick will always say, well, she'll it'll go from one end, which is why he beats the shit out of you, why don't you leave? And she goes, because I love him, right? Yeah. And then the other sense of it will be a great guy who is taking care of her, taking care of her kid, and then
taking care of his kid that's not
and
his.
And she is testing the 16th person that is not the baby, and she still comes out. You better take a bitch. Mm-hmm. It was 16 months. You tested 16 motherfuckers. Like, where? Like, for me, if I'm a bigger hoe that I have tested 16 people to find out, and none of them would have. At
if
least
you lost 16 games in a row.
Right, you would
don't
go
run out of that dugout.
Right, like you go, you're like a little bit, you're a little shit. Bit more. You go, you know, it was a time when I was more promiscuous. Maybe, you know, it could be him, but it may not be him. And let's just go to the test and see what says. They come out and go, you had a father.
100,000%.
I'm 112%. He got two eyes. You got two eyes.
Look at him breathing.
He got a little ass dick, just like you too.
Yeah,
like,
he's throwing some bullshit.
What the fuck is like? Where is the humility in that when you're wrong so many times?
The humility is when they fucking run in the back crying in the 37th and nigga says no.
Then they come back on this 39th one and do this. Motherfucker, take care of your kids. It's your baby. And it's just, I mean, that's the most extreme situation. Yeah. But it's like, I find it, you know, if you go, she goes, it would look this, you know, you brush your teeth and they go, I don't care.
Yeah.
Now, what's your response? I don't care.
How can you not care? How can you just not care? I don't. So you just don't care about that my feelings are hurt.
You're not trying hard enough.
No, I don't care.
Wow,
you got to double down. You have to. And then when they manipulate it into, oh, so you don't care about my feelings that I'm hurt by it? No, not at all.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's good to know.
Then I go.
It's good to know.
Then
that
I go.
You don't give a shit.
Then I'll go. You want to break up? And they're like, well, I don't.
You cut right to the chase.
You want
to
break up? Let's break up. Then she goes, well, I didn't say. And if she goes yes, then you lose her anyway, so you don't have to deal with this crazy bitch anymore.
That's another thing, too, about, like, that I learned later on about, like, dudes and, you know, women dealing with dudes. When I will date a girl and they seem to be kind of taking me for granted and they're like, well, fuck, you did it. My whole thing is like, hey, you can do better. Good luck. Like, you know what I mean? Like, there's a lot of dudes out there who are fucking most of them are just shitheads, idiots.
Boy, I might as well have that crocheted on a pillow at this point.
But it's just like, hey, have a good time. Speech. Have a good time dating. You know, dudes are like annoying.
I have friends.
So just let them go. So it's like, just let them go dudes. You
I
know?
One time went, if you don't like it, the door's right there. And we were outside. I'm like, this doesn't even make sense. But you know what I mean.
The door, Starbucks, bitch.
But it's like, they like, you know, it ain't a bunch, it ain't a bar full of George Clooney's waiting for you. You know what I mean? It's a bunch of married. I think the. I was thinking about today, actually. For dudes, when you meet, because I met a hot girl last night. She was really hot. And she had a boyfriend, which is fine. Like, obviously. Whatever. You meet these hot chicks, and they, it's like, yeah, you probably have a boyfriend.
Right.
I think what happens with women is they'll meet really good dudes, and the dude will still want to fuck them, but they're married.
Right.
Or they're a girl. They're just cheating.
But here's the other thing. The reason why the guy's good in the first place is because he's married. Because you are not the problem, you are the solution. You are the
escape.
Yeah, the escape to this shit that he's stuck in, and so he and then you appreciate him, and you he feels great because you appreciate him.
Right.
Let me just say this real quick, because I say this all the time. It's there's a book out. I've referenced this book several times. It's called How to Get Anybody to Do Anything by David Lieberman. People keep asking me about some of the books that I read, and the book is just a human behavioral book. And one of the things that it says is that what creates emotional attachment is not when you do things for the girl, it's when she does something for you. It's you give her purpose in her life in the context of you in her life.
Right.
So that's why you get a lot of chicks, chick who's dating some dude who's in and out of jail, and she's bailing him out, and she's stuck because she's, you know, I need to save him. Gives her something to do. My marriage, I said this several times, my marriage went to shit because of that, because I was so independent. Anything my wife didn't want to do, she didn't have to do. If she didn't want to cook, fuck it, I go get food. We'll get it cooked. You don't want to clean? I'll get somebody to clean. And I thought doing that was, man, I'm a really cool dude. Like, I'm a really cool husband. Mm-hmm. But all it did was just create this distance, because then, and I didn't really have needs. I had always taken care of my needs anyway. I was so independent. And ultimately, we just ended up becoming so, what happened was she just felt useless in the context of my life. And then she started having her own interests. And then, and the other thing was that she was so selfish anyway. I enabled the selfishness. And then it was just like she didn't really want to do anything for anybody. Which is funny, because she actually called me.
How long were you married?
I was married like 8 years.
Oh, wow.
She called me like many years later, and she was like, I need you to fix me. I was like, you destroyed me for all other men, blah, blah, blah. And I go, what are you talking about? And she goes, well, my boyfriend, he says the same things that you do, and he's not honest. And so she tells me a story about how the guy's phone rings. He picks it up and he says, hello. He says, oh, all right, I'll call you back later. And he hangs up the phone. So it was
cheating.
No, he wasn't even cheating. Uh-oh. It was his brother's side bitch, right? His brother's side. Now, he didn't want to say that that's who it was, because now if his brother has a side bitch, then he has a side bitch. So he's lying to her, because here's the thing. As men, we lie to you because we like you. Mm. We don't give a fuck about you. We don't lie. We don't give a fuck about your feelings. And we'll tell you, nah, bitch, this is my other bitch. I'll see you later. I got to talk to her. Let me go. I'm going in. I'm going to be nice enough to go in the other room. Or you stay there and talk to her in front of her.
Yeah.
So so the guy, he lied about it, but she heard the woman's voice. And she was like, who was that on the phone? And he goes, oh, this is my boy from work, blah, 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 blah. Now he's just lying he's lying about shit that he's not even doing, because he just doesn't want the argument. And I've been in that position. I was in that position with my ex-wife, where I was just lying about something because I just didn't want to fight. I wanted to keep the peace. And so she goes, you know, he says, you know, the only reason why I lied to you is because I didn't want you to freak out, which is exactly what I said. And she goes, he says same things that you say, and that's what scares me. Blah, 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 blah. And I go, okay. So I'm curious. I go, you know, she goes, when you're with a man, he should this. And she always said, same thing with me. She had a list of things that you should do as a husband, right? But then when I asked her, what do you think you should do as a wife?
Yeah.
She was like, be faithful. And I go, okay, and what else, bitch? And she didn't have any other, well, be faithful. And I was like, okay. So I said to her, I said, okay, so what is this guy? I go, what do you do for him? And she goes, well, what is he like? And he goes, well, he just likes peace. He doesn't like to fight. He's non-confrontational. And I goes, but you fight with him, right? All the time, right? Because you did it with me. And she goes, well, I'm more mature now, so sometimes I will catch myself and I'll change it, right? And I go, what do you want from him? And she goes, I want him to be monogamous. And I said, so, like, what percentage of the time do you start to fight with him and then stop yourself? And she was like, I don't know, maybe 30% of the time I will stop myself.
A third of the time.
A third of the time.
Wait, so, wait, that she'll stop herself.
That she'll stop herself.
So yeah. That's 66%, is it?
So I said, I'm curious. You give him 30% of what he wants, so then he should only be monogamous to you for 30% of the time.
Ooh, you're a lawyer, Tom. That's yeah.
I go,
hard to argue those percentages.
That sounds like a contract.
It does. Which it is a contract. Yeah. I mean, a relationship is a contract. I said, so
you entered into an agreement.
You know, out of every 10 bitches, he should fuck 6 out of 10. Right?
Yeah. I take those. That's some good odds.
That's some good odds, right?
6 out of 10.
And she goes, you know what?
Let's roll over.
She goes, I probably just need to be by myself. I go, yeah, that's why we're divorced. Because you should be by yourself. Because you're horribly selfish and you're an awful person.
Yeah. That's what was that like, being married 8 years and then getting divorced? Was it horrible?
It was crazy because she was kind of the chick. It's funny because, guys, I don't talk about this. I mean, I've talked about it early on in the early parts of the podcast. But she was the woman who I thought I would be with for the rest of my life. Like, a guy doesn't marry a chick that he might be with. She was like, I say... The terminology, she was like my couch. You know how, like, you know you're in your fucking...
Like, this is the couch I'm going to have forever.
This is my couch, man. How could I not be with... And I think that's what makes us as men...
So you would lie down on her and watch TV?
And watch TV, just you know, like, flip she's always over. There. Just, you know, if I spilled a little soda on her, I just kind of rub it in. I wouldn't even clean it
just
up.
Pour seltzer on her.
Just and, And that's how we go, okay, this is the woman I can't see myself with anybody else. So, okay, I guess I guess so. Why not? We're going to rock forever. And it was almost like I have friends like that. Like, I've become friends with Harry, and I feel like we'll be friends forever. Yeah. Like, I can't imagine what would happen to not for us not to be friends. So I just wanted to bring you on to witness. Harry, would you marry me?
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Yes. Yes. Yeah. State of New York, it's time. I'm not going to do better, let's be honest, financially.
Yeah. You have seen your better days, Harry. So, I mean, you better jump on this.
I'm getting in shape, but still, you're right. Fair enough.
So, but yeah. I mean, it was literally like, you know, it was the chick who I could, and then all of a sudden, I couldn't believe that this was ending. And then I was doing what
when that's going on, because I went through that with a long term relationship where, like, I didn't know what was happening, and I see it now that, like, okay, I allowed this to kind of happen. But what was your frame of reference? Was it just like, I can't believe this person has become this, or I can't believe this is losing control?
I don't even think it was. Oh my God, why don't you love me more? Like, you were the person I was going to be with forever.
Yeah.
Like, why are you doing this? You're fucking this up. I couldn't be with anybody else. Right. Why would you fucking destroy this?
The weirdest thing about that, because, like, I mean, I've never been married, but when you go through something like that, what's so weird to me is when you get past it,
yeah,
you look back and you're like, oof. What the fuck was I? Yeah. Like, I can't believe I was so upset about that. Yeah. Like, because then... It's because when you're going through it, you're just like, oh my God, never, ever, I'm never going to feel, you know, better.
Again.
But then later you're just like, oh my God, like, I'm like so much, I like this so much better.
Right.
And why did I fight for that or stay in that?
Here's a real crazy thing is when you let it go and then you fight and then there's this moment where you hook up again and then you're like, oh my God, I feel so fulfilled. And then she starts doing the same and you're like,
I'm not even at that point.
This is why I woke up with this bitch. I remember
feeling,
now.
That feeling comes back immediately.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
Every,
yeah.
I think with every succession, like the downtime.
Yeah,
when
yeah.
you return back yeah, to the yeah. anger, you're like, is just less and less.
This bitch was selfish and didn't do shit. She didn't give a fuck about me. Now I remember why we're not together, right. And it just becomes very really obvious. So it's funny because like sometimes I'll do like breakup counseling with dudes and stuff like that, and it's a lot of times I will advise the guy to do a certain thing, do this, do that, do this. This is how you deal with this. And then he most of the time they don't listen to me because they can't see it. They can't.
They're not in that, the mind. Your mind's not in.
Yeah, they're not in the mindset. And they'll call me because they figure, oh, Dante knows how to handle this. And then they will listen to me and things will start turning around. And then they will, they almost all the time start to, they want a freestyle battle. Like, yo, I'm going off the cuff.
I'm going off the top.
Son, I'm
going
listening.
Off the
right,
top,
right.
Son.
I'm listening yeah. to you. Everything is working, Dante. You know what? I got
Bro,
this.
I got this.
Bam.
Bam.
Right.
Sam. Lamb.
Sam.
Ham.
Sam.
No, just let me go straight for you, bro.
Sorry.
Yeah. No, I am. But no, it's weird. Yeah. Once you getting through it is.
Yeah.
You kind of, but you're, when you go through something like that, I mean, that's why being married for that long ago, it's like, you're just not, you are like kind of crazy. Like your mind just isn't working.
It's not in the same way.
You're
exactly.
filtering everything in a really bad way.
And then everything that I tell the listeners now is the things that I did myself.
Right.
To get back. Lay the five bricks. Like I would go out and talk to five chicks every day.
Right.
I would speak to every chick that I came across with. Hey, nice hair, beautiful eyes. This is it. And then I got over that. Then I started getting my gear up, like my clothes. I started dressing better. I would get my manicures and my pedicures. I'd make sure I was clean, and I was sharp and put together. And that gave me confidence. And then meeting women and being and just realizing, you know, as you get older, especially as comics, we experience things on a whole nother level.
Right.
You don't even realize. Like, it's crazy. Like, here's what's amazing.
Can I get another Red Bull? I'm sorry.
You want anything else?
Do you have sugar free by any chance? If not, don't worry.
Yeah, we got one, right?
I don't remember if we have.
I bought two.
I'm sorry, that's a good tangent in the middle of your story.
Oh, there we go.
I thought I was gonna be better at doing that slyly.
And but you want ice?
Nah, I'm good. Okay. This is good. Thanks.
So, but we literally were like, like it was a situation where I started to build myself up and to build my confidence and do these things.
It
and
is
get back
you
in
do have to do that. Yeah. That's why when you're going through it and you're at the beginning of it, it's you're like this is and you've been through it already. You're like I can't believe I have to do this again.
Well, here's what's crazy. When I see a guy and he starts falling in love, you're fucking up. Like you still got to keep your game sharp.
Oh yeah, you can't. When
How
you start
you
being
hunt?
Into it, you can't let on.
How are you gonna hunt if all your guns are rusted and they're in it? You throw them in the shed. You should be cleaning your guns in the living room while she's watching. And she's like, "Well, you we're married. You don't gotta hunt no more, bitch. We never know." I am always keeping the human resource department. I am always taking applications. So you stay on board because
that's one thing I've learned. It's like anything can happen, dude. Like there's no rules go out the window.
I don't. Is it bad that I don't perceive marriage as a forever thing at all, or like any relationship is forever?
I don't think.
Well, you're gonna die. I mean, it's not because you're gonna die.
No, I know that, but I mean, even to the end of that, like the idea of being with one person for the rest, like life changes, and I don't see it happening.
It's a binding contract. I think there should be. I think you should go. Listen, let's do this for 10 years. Or let's do this for 5, and then we'll revisit this contract after 5. And
it's quite
a proposal. Are you gonna like do that proposal in the middle of a baseball game?
I think I'm gonna do that. I think if I ever do it again, like, let's check this out for 5.
Yeah.
If it works out, if not, then we just and then she goes, "Wow, man, my contract is up in 5.
I better step up my game.
I better have a good season."
Exactly. It's like an election coming up.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I better start
let's lower taxes.
Yeah, it should be like presidential term.
It should be a presidential
every, like,
term.
5 years.
Because the
arrogancy
and the audacity of that. I had a dude that I helped out, man. this guy called me.
What about being single?
He was going through a breakup. And what happened was he told me he was going up for a break. He was going through this breakup. Well, he wasn't even sure if he was going through the breakup. But what happened was he called me up. He's single, right? Retired cop and got hurt on the job. And he was a captain or a sergeant. So he's making good money. Got full pay because he got hurt on the job. He's got his own place, right? She has 3 kids. I think she's 44. He's 37. She has 3 kids. Their father is in an insane asylum, right? She's taking care of these kids. Then he's with her. She gets cancer, right?
Oh my God.
He goes through the whole cancer thing with her. He's changing her fucking shit bag, right?
Yep. See where this is going.
This is one of those horror films. Don't go in the woods, bitch. Yeah.
Right, right.
And
well, it sounds like if she dumped him, it seems like that's where it's going. That sounds like the best part of the relationship.
Oh, that is the best part of it.
Is that what happened?
He became the father, the only father to the kids that they now. Naturally, she's a crazy bitch, so the kids are nuts. Every time he tries to implement some kind of
the other guy's an insane asylum.
Oh, he's gone. It
doesn't matter what the last candidate did.
I'm just saying, like, if that just gives you a history of what happens to
who dates her.
What their wake is.
If they're like, my last guy, my last boyfriend is in an insane asylum.
Oh, really?
Like, oh,
so
cool.
I'm
going to
step up.
Well, I'm sure that was just him and purely coincidental.
He changed her shit bags, the whole shit.
Changed my own shit bags. I'll be honest with you.
I'm gonna pay somebody.
I didn't know shit bags were so prevalent. I'm sorry, but yeah.
He's the only discipline these kids had. He's taking these kids out, spending his money on them constantly, whatever, whatever. She comes to his house because it's the only sanctuary that she has. She didn't fuck his friends, but she goes, you know, I don't like the fact that you make these decisions and you don't include me, right? And then she decides.
We'll talk about this after you're done shitting your pants.
She invites a exchange student to live in the house.
Okay.
Right? So he's like, why would you invite this fucking exchange? You don't have enough time and energy for your own kids. Why would you fucking do this? Well, I thought it would be a good experience. Now, she didn't discuss this with him or nothing. Whatever. He goes, Why would you fucking do this and not even... So he's angry.
This was at his house?
No, at her house.
At her house, okay.
But he's over there taking care of her kids,
right.
The whole
now
shit.
Now there's just another guy there.
Yeah, just another exchange student there, right. Fucking from Slovenia.
Throw another guy in the mix.
He's got a wool hat with ear flaps. And and he's like, what the fuck are you doing? And she goes, well, you know, I don't like that you're telling me what to do. And that's just like, and you know, I really need some time to think this out and see where this is going. Bitch, I changed your shit bag.
Ugh.
And so he caught. So
that was days ago.
Here's what's funny.
First of all, I feel like I would just be out of there on that day. The shit bag. The first shit bag. This isn't working.
As soon as he's explaining the concept of the shit bag, like, you're putting on your shoes, tying on your shoes. No, you can finish.
When the shit bag slips out of your hand because it's got a little sweaty, and it hits the ground and splashes on your Capizios. How fucking awesome is that?
So I gotta know what. So what happened?
So it was actually a friend of Kevin Brennan, and he said, "Look, call Dante up." Right.
So this was, she basically was like, I have to think about stuff. So like, we can't see each other anymore.
I need some time to sort this.
Right.
And you know, I say that all the time. I say this on the show. Anytime a chick goes, I need some time. I hit her in the face with a calendar. You can have all the time.
Exactly.
Bitch.
That's exactly it. You go, cool. Hey, you know what? Have good fun. That's my whole thing. It goes back to like good fucking luck. Like you can do better. Feel fucking free.
I'm gonna start hitting a bitch.
I ain't standing around with a
sundial.
That's the attitude you gotta. Yeah, you got it. There's no like, and when you do that, and I've had this.
Yeah.
When you do that, they won't fucking. They don't leave you alone.
Yeah.
They just keep coming back. You got to be like, I had
leave
this
me
couple
the fuck alone.
Where I had to be like, stop, like it's done. Like, you wanted me out of the apartment. I'm out of the apartment. I'm out of your fucking life. Like, it's over. I don't know if you could, like, and it's, I always have that attitude. Like, you can do better. Hey, have at it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like,
go for it. I told this, and then he,
I just don't want to be with anyone who doesn't want to be with me. It's like, why would I ever want to be with
Why
them?
Would you want to
like,
be with someone?
Fuck yourself.
Well, it's a good point. That's a really good logic.
Well, a
point.
Lot of guys don't have enough confidence to think that they could do better.
And I'm like, you can't do better than a 44-year-old chick with 3 kids, a husband in the asylum, and shit bags.
Yeah.
I think you could do better.
I think you can do better than someone who doesn't want to be with you.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, I can do better than that.
Yeah. What's funny is he called, so I was counseling him, and I was like, look, do not contact her again. And then, you know, they were dealing with the fact that he had his stuff. Some of her stuff was over there, and blah, blah, blah. He's trying to get her. And then she was supposed to come and get some her computer, because his back is fucked up from the injury.
Right.
She was supposed to come and get her computer, and then she's supposed to come at 3 o'clock. She doesn't come at 3 o'clock. And I was like, well, you tell her she can't come now. You come when you say you're going to come. You're not going to have me sit and wait. For your shit. If you want me to do it, I'll push it outside the door and you can get it. And if somebody steals it, you can get it. But I'm not, you don't get, here's what, and she was like, wow, you've never been late for me. No, bitch, the difference is I'm not your dude no more.
Right now, yeah.
You don't get those privileges.
You don't get those privileges anymore. You have to stop. When you say
that's
it's
VIP
over,
treatment.
You gotta be, it's gotta be over in pragmatically.
Yeah.
The dude I talk about that his wife hadn't worked in 15 years, built a house for her, all kinds of shit. And he, all of a sudden, she goes, I want a divorce. Bitch ain't working 15 years. He called me up. I said, you give her the divorce today.
Yeah.
So 2 days later, he filed for divorce. 2 days later, the door rang. They were eating dinner. Boom, 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 boom. Mrs. So-and-so? Yes. Well, he served the papers at dinner time the next. She was like, what is this? She says, divorce papers. You said you wanted a divorce. Now you got it.
Right.
And then you don't just give it to her in paper, but then you give it to her pragmatically. So right after that weekend, she was like, babe, the oil light came on
the, like, good luck with that.
Oh, yeah. Go get it fixed.
Yeah. Figure it out.
You don't get, because you stop need to know.
Oh, I know. Yeah, I've had that before. I once dated a girl and then we broke up, and she would call me when anything happened and just cry. Like, and they were mean to me, and I was like,
I'm not your dude.
I don't handle this department anymore. Like, I don't.
Listen, you have the wrong department.
You're not blowing me. I'm not gonna like listen to you cry about someone at work being mean to you.
Like handing in your badge and gun. It's done. You want to retire? Yeah, like,
good luck.
You want to still fight crime, motherfucker? No. Yeah.
You don't get to keep the badge and gun.
Yeah, girl. Would like call me and like ask me for help with things, and I was just like, what are you like, are you fucking, I mean, again it was a reasonable thing. I'm like, are you your fuck, the audacity that you would even do this. Like,
because
that you would,
did you say that though?
I did, I was like, well, I would just be like, at first I was nice, but then I was like, stop, I don't want any part of this anymore. So I mean, it's one of those things, sometimes you just have to be a dick. Like,
well, here's that's even too much of that's, to me, I think that's too nice.
Well, I mean, I got meaner later.
Yeah, but I mean, I think that's what you have to do. Like, here, you know, this is, and this is another theory that I was talking about. When we go, I'm not going to tolerate this. What you're really doing when you say I'm not going to tolerate is this, is you're tolerating it. You're forgiving that behavior in that moment because you've allowed it. You're going, the next time you do this, I won't, because she's already done it.
Right.
So there has to be a consequence for the fact that you did it. So when she does it, there needs to be an action. So when she goes, they were mean to me, you hang up.
Yeah.
And then she calls, did I no, I hung up on you.
Right.
Why'd you hang up on me? Because I don't give a fuck what happens to you.
Yeah.
And then how could you? You're such a dick. Yeah, I'm a dick. Yeah, I'm a dick to somebody who's not my chick.
Right.
Bars. That shit rhymed. There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. There you go.
Gun. Fun.
All right.
Dick. Quick.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to freestyle.
I can freestyle.
Freestyle, Tom.
I can.
Pretty good.
Do freestyle.
You have a beat. Do freestyle.
We can get a
beat. No, you know how. No.
I will get you a beat.
I'm not. I'm going to embarrass
but
myself.
But the thing is, you have to, like, you have to set those standards up and you get the certain privileges. There was a girl I was going out with for a minute. Actually, Tom was there.
Was that girl I saw at the... Are you dating her now?
No, not anymore. It didn't work out. But
were you dating her then? That was like three weeks ago.
That was first date.
Oh, that was fast.
Yeah.
Was that a month ago?
No, it was a little more than a month ago.
No, it was right after September 11th.
Oh, really? Okay, so it was less than
that. Because someone made a September 11th joke.
That one was a short one. That was your first date? Yeah.
Oh, wow.
A short one. But there's certain like, I'll help you out, do whatever. But the second we're not going out anymore, like, no, I'm not doing any of that.
You don't get any of that.
No, immediately. That's kind of when they freak out.
They go, holy shit, I don't get to keep doing the same shit.
And I guess that's when it comes in with guys, like if you go through a breakup. And if the girl broke up with you, guys freak out and they do everything wrong. Where they like keep contact, or when the girl contacts them, they're just like, "What do you need?" But you got to be like, even if you do, if you want to get back together with them,
the worst thing to do is not.
You can't have contact with them, and you gotta, because you have to make them like.
This is what it is.
Oh shit!
This is the Tom McCaffrey experience.
Yeah,
you either want to be with it or not. Now let me show you what it is without me.
Yeah.
Exactly. And I'm sorry if I interrupted you.
No, not at all. That's all. But it's the same thing at the end. Is like, yeah, you know, whatever. I still want to be friends. And I was just no. And it's like, and not to be a dick, but guess what? I don't take my friends out to dinner.
Right.
I just don't. I don't have the, not from a lack of desire to do it. I don't have the time to do it. Like, do you understand?
I don't want to do it. Oh, so you just that's how you are. You have sex with me. Yeah, that's how I am. Yes.
Yeah.
That's really fucked up. Okay. Well, then
That's really funny when that happens, when you're in a position like that where you're not fighting anymore and they say horrible things, and you're like, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I'm good with that.
And then they're like, well, then it's over, and you're like, all right, it is.
It already was.
Yeah, yeah. Like, okay, well, bye. And she goes,
You don't want to fight for us? What?
Well, it's like, I tried. You didn't want it to be normal.
You didn't want to be normal. You're broke.
Right.
Yeah. No, I mean, I've had that. And the thing is, I've been through a lot of breaks. And, like, they really hurt. Yeah. But from my experience, it's like, the more it happens, you're like, I've gotten through it.
Yeah.
I mean, it still sucks, but it's like, I've lived through these. Right. And the last thing,
yeah.
I'm not going to hang on to something. Yeah. Like, it's like letting go is the only thing you can do. I saw something where women are like cats. It's like when they kind of like wander off, you kind of just got to let them wander off and they'll find their way back home. You can't force them back to you.
I don't really like cats. So when they wander off, I lock the door.
Fuck cats.
Right.
And I try to hit you with a shoe.
Yeah,
but Andre, you
that's how they're like
you
women.
Think they're
no,
black magic.
I'm talking about women. No,
you're talking about women now.
Yeah,
but I think that's a kind of a good analogy because it's like you know, and the tendency a lot of guys have is to like when they sort of wander off,
it's to try
to chase
them.
Be like, where are they? Get them back here. But it's like the women, they're feeling one way one day, and then the next day they're not feeling that way.
Here's what's crazy: when you don't chase, is when they will not stop chasing you. And so, guys, it's so counterintuitive to the way that because we socialize with men before we socialize with women. When you're on the playground, you socialize with guys, and that's where we learn to socialize. It's like, so this is my friend. It was funny. Somebody was telling me about this little girl. She was like 4 years old, and her father, and she was like, Tabitha's your friend. And she was like, Tabitha's not my friend, and I don't have to be nice to her. And he goes, why? Why isn't Tabitha your friend? Well, I asked her for two cookies, and she didn't give them to me. And the father goes, yeah, but didn't you not give Tabitha your cookies? And she goes, yes, but I don't like Tabitha. She likes me. And that was her fucking hurt. This 4-year-old kid is
perfectly pure,
she's gonna be
honest.
Pure honest. Well, I can ask her for everything because she likes me. I have the advantage.
Right.
So why can't I take advantage of her? She likes me. I don't like her.
I think I dated her.
7 times.
I know. It's weird, like, dating women than thinking that it's going to be a different experience.
It was
like, I don't understand. You guys seem all alike in a way.
I say that all the time. All and women get mad at me. They're like, you don't know women. You're not a man. I go, no, I don't know women.
I've slept with 2,000 of you. Shut up.
Wow.
Don't fucking tell me. I know you're all, and every girl.
So all guys are the same? All guys are the same?
Yeah, kind of. Yeah, kind of too.
Pretty much, bitch.
Never mind. I have nothing else to add.
No, then they go, wow, I'm different. No, you're not, bitch. No, you're not. Even the way you say I'm different.
You know how I know?
100 bitches said it exactly the same way.
Every time.
I've had this same conversation 200 times.
I guess there's degrees.
Yeah, some there's degrees, are, but some still the same.
I have my own theories. I think old men are crazy. And I think it's a scale of 1 to 10.
Is that your theory?
No, no, no. The theory is all bitches are crazy?
No, no, no. It's not that. Beige Phillip rule number one.
Yeah, but it's not that. They always tell me, oh, I'm not crazy or I'm different.
Oh, it's like, a degree. No. It is a degree.
I said it's just of level of, it's 1 to 10, but women's scale is 5 and up. You're just either a 5 level crazy or up. You're not below. Nothing is below 5.
I've gone out with a couple of girls lately, recently, and they were like, yeah, we're crazy. They were like, yeah, women are crazy. It's weird. Maybe it's because they're older or something, but they were just upfront being like, one of them was just like, yeah, we're all crazy. Like, we are all crazy. Yeah. And she was like, I mean, I only went out there a few times, but like, first of all, a few times, how shitty are they going to be in the third time you're hanging out with them?
Right.
So she seemed really chill and cool, but I thought that was a weird thing where it's like now the women I will go out with will tell me up front that they're out of their minds.
I'm out of my fucking. And here's what's funny. Female comics talk about it all the time. Talk about how they're crazy. And
they have to be.
Yeah.
Because you're already kind of crazy to be a comedian.
Yeah.
And then if you're a woman and a comedian, it's just a double thing. Like,
but they won't.
I'm not trying to be, but I just.
No.
Because comedians just are already kind of fucking loopy.
Yeah.
So
to put yourself in that kind of judgment every second.
To put yourself,
you get on stage and you're being judged every second that you're on stage, every minute of it.
Something was lacking.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I mean, I don't think I'm crazy, but I think I'm not even that crazy.
I love the challenge of it.
I love to challenge. You know, the challenge of getting of putting yourself under that judgment and winning. Yeah. I love that. I mean, even my
I love it less and less.
Really?
I think it's fine. As I've gotten older, I've gotten less like, which I guess is a good thing. Like, I don't care as much if a crowd, like now if a crowd doesn't like me, it used to really get me upset. Now I'm like, well, it ain't for everybody. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not like, I'm going to win you back. I'm like, I don't give a shit. I don't even know you guys. You all seem annoying. Well, like, if you don't like it, I'm going to leave. You know, I mean, I'm going to do it and leave. And it's not going to ruin my night anymore.
Right. Well, it doesn't, but I mean, I like, I will go on stage and shoot a hostage when I get on stage. Start with them right away. Just fuck with somebody. And then put myself in a hole to see if I... Okay, see
that
how
sounds
gonna,
like a really rough show that you're talking about. Shooting a hostage.
Yeah, I will shoot a hostage. I come out...
Are you doing a lot of bank robbery shows?
I will do that. And you know how they go, everybody down on the floor, I don't do that. I shoot the first dude in the head. And then I go, everybody get down. And then somehow everybody gets down. Everybody gets down.
Are you doing the shoot the hostage like in the movie Speed?
Exactly.
Is that what you're talking
about?
Yeah, when he shoots Jeff Daniels?
Yeah, just shoot the
guy. Take him out of the equation. Shoot the hostage. That's my Keanu Reeves impression.
Probably terrible advice. Probably not at all accurate. Never ever shoot the hostage.
No, you'll like go to jail. Like they don't. The cops aren't gonna be like, "Good job." Well, I guess you don't tell them you did it purposely.
That was great stuff. Shooting that hostage. That was classy.
Classy.
Right off the top. All right, we got some people.
We're gonna help some listener mail. Hang out. All right, Tom. We're gonna help some people.
Okay.
With your great expertise.
Yeah, all right.
Nice. Here we go. Hey, Dante, I'm a 21-year-old college
student.
What's
up, motherfucker?
Started hooking up with this cute white girl in the spring. Well, white girl, and now we know what you are if you're describing it as white girl. Not that there's anything wrong with that. Cute white girl in the spring at my school. She made me work for it at first. Had to take her out like 3 or 4 times before she gave it up. That's a bit much. We were having sex the entire spring. Everything was going great. All right. Felt like I had her mind pimped perfectly.
Mm.
When the summer hit, we rarely talked to each other at all, which I was perfectly fine with. Once school started again in the fall, we started hooking up again. During the first week, she told me she wanted to know what we are. I responded saying I wasn't looking for a relationship. She didn't say anything, and we continued to hook up. One day after hooking up, I caved in and told her that she was my girl. I did it because I knew she was uncomfortable, and I enjoyed hooking up with her. Now I've been with her for over a month and I'm miserable with the expectations that come with the boyfriend label. Feel like I gave her the label for dishonest reasons. How do I honestly and righteously break up with this girl?
First of all, if you listen to the show, one of the Beige Phillip rules is put yourself first. If you don't, she won't. Mm. So the simple fact that you caved in because she felt she would feel better, now you've made her happy and she's still not happy, probably.
And he did it because he didn't think he couldn't do better. Because
he pimped his manhood.
Yeah.
He discounted his manhood. Here's the thing. You don't do something just to please somebody else because they want you to do it. It's insincere. It's not what you want to do. And why would you be in a relationship that's insincere in the first place? You don't like her like that. You don't like her like that. That's just the way it is. You got to be willing to, what Tom said, you got to be willing to take the L. If you want to go out there and look for somebody else to hook up with that's going to give you I can't tell you how many girls I dated who wanted, pressured me to get married. I didn't marry them. They got married. They had a kid and they're divorced. Endless.
Right.
Endless chicks sure. who are divorced and then they'll call me up. Hey, what?
Right.
I remember
right.
that fucking way he used to fuck the
That's
shit the out
of
me.
That's the whole cat going, yeah. let him go away thing.
And I'm like, good luck, Rich. Good luck.
Oh, yeah.
Good luck. And they always come sniffing around later. Now you got a 4-year-old. And your baby's daddy don't pay child support, and he don't spend no time with the kid. But this is what you wanted, bitch.
First of all, I feel like I'm the worst person to give any relationship advice. But with this guy, it sounds like, first of all, he's super young.
Yeah,
and it sounds like that he was just kind of like banging or having like a very casual thing, and didn't want it to go to that level. And then that's a really bad feeling once you do that, you don't want to do it because you feel like you've completely undermined yourself.
Right,
haven't been true to yourself, and then now you're like in a relate. You're like, oh shit,
I'm in a
relate. Didn't. Yeah, you did it because you felt like bad.
Right.
That's not a good
reason to do anything.
But the only thing I'll say about women and dating, in my experience, is like. I feel like the only power we have as men is the power to walk away from them because they're so not used to guys being able to walk away. Because, I mean,
well, there's more power. I mean, there's the power to get another bitch. There's a power to be honest. The power to
that falls under. Yeah, but I think that's
you got
to
be willing to take the L.
Because I think, and I don't even. I mean, yeah, exactly. But I feel like it's I feel like powerless. Like, I mean, women have. That's why when I hear the whole thing of like, women are like, you know, we want equal rights to be equal with men. I'm like, dude, you have no idea how unequal the world. Like, you guys run everything.
Yeah, yeah.
Like we are at the mercy of women.
Well,
we just
had a podcast before you, and we were talking about how. What did they say? What was the? It was bigger than I thought. That 75% was 75%. Harvard law. Harvard.
70%, I believe.
70% of all domestic abuse is perpetuated by women. And we don't report any of it.
Really?
Right.
Like, men this don't. Is physical?
Physical women beat men 70% of the time.
Yeah, that's bad.
And they don't... And we, because you
can't. Of course,
can't,
you don't report. Hello, police.
Hello.
I'm the biggest pussy in the world.
Right. Right. And he's going, yes. Really? Yes. Really?
Send someone over.
Hey, O'Malley, get a load of this.
Yes, I'll hold so you can laugh.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
It's fucked up.
Can you put us on speakerphone so we can hear this?
70% and 0% reports.
Who said this?
A Harvard study found.
Okay, so you know it's real.
It's Harvard study, right? I heard it was 50%, and he just read this. I heard it was 50% before I've heard that.
And
before.
I mean that you know, and it goes to the thing with like you know the women who getting when someone beats you up, and you're like, well, we'll give it another shot. Like I don't like. Why would you ever just be single? Like some guys beating the shit out of you.
Well, he is.
I know it's hard. Hard to leave. It's right. You know they say it's hard to leave that situation for women because they're like
it's
the guy
to
is going
to
murder me.
It's hard to leave for a guy as well if a chick is beating on you.
Definitely. Yeah.
What does he say? I left because she was beating me. Like how does that go over at the softball?
I mean, clearly. team. Something you got some problems going on with self-esteem. If you're letting
a girl beat you up. We're also talking about 70%. I mean, there's a lot more to it because as a guy, we're going, well, I mean, come on, I'm a man. I mean, like whatever. She gets mad, and
you can't do anything back.
And it's all this other shit that goes on. But you know that amongst other things. I mean, if one of the things is we both have fucked up situations. I mean, men and women. But if you want equal rights, it's got to be equal. I get jumped on this all the time with that Ray Rice thing. I say the Ray Rice thing was equal.
Wait, a football player. What did he do?
That he knocked the girl out in the elevator.
Oh, right.
But here's what I said.
Was she hitting him or something? Nothing I'm defending.
She hit him and she spit in his face. And I said, if a guy spit in my face, I would knock him the fuck out. So that's equal. That's how you want to be treated like men. That's how I would treat a guy.
Yeah, now, this is an iffy.
Nah, I think it's only iffy because we are uncomfortable dealing with the math of it.
It's iffy where now you can't say anything without everyone getting mad.
Right, but but it's not a situation where that's not true. If you want to be treated like a guy, that's how I would treat a guy.
Bill Burr has a really good bit about something like this, about something like that with equality and how it's always like, oh, these women are beaten by these men. And he's like, look, some women are doing some shitty.
Right. Let me. It's not. Hey, baby, how you doing?
And then things like they fucked. I just fucked your friend.
Right. Chris Rock has one of those
things that you're like, okay, like it just doesn't come.
Right.
And he's not defending it, but he's saying like,
I want to hear the soundtrack before the punch.
I've dealt with that. I've dealt with some women who do, you know, they know how to fucking get you.
Sure.
And like, you know, you gotta just
shout out to my mom.
And you just, that's when it gets scary.
Yeah.
That's when breakups get scary.
Yeah.
Cause then you're like, I've had this with women like way down in the past where it's like, I don't know what this girl is gonna do today.
Yeah.
I know she's got something in store for me. And it's gonna be really bad.
It's a kaleidoscope of amusement.
And that's why when you go through things like that, you just have to cut them off and like you just can't do anything.
Oh, how about
you
this?
You can't react.
I got an email from a guy. He was like, you know, the girl hit on him, he's fucking her, and then she goes stop. And he stops, and he goes. She goes. I just feel like you took advantage of me, and
oh,
you're like,
God.
Wow.
See, that's another. Oh my.
Mid fuck. Really?
Oh, yeah.
Holy shit.
I misread this.
Like what the fuck? Who wants to be in that situation? Like what the fuck? And he stopped. But she was just. I just feel wrong about this, and I feel like you took advantage of the situation because you knew that I had a crush on you and you're like, what? I had a guy.
It's like the Kobe thing.
Here's a one better. There was a chick who liked the guy. He sent me this email. This girl liked the guy. He was friends with her boyfriend. She pushed up on him and he pushed her away. He said, look, I'm not fucking with you. You're my friend's girlfriend, and then she left the kitchen. Like, he pushed her away in the kitchen, and then she told her friends that he hurt her because he made advances and said that he pushed up on her, and this is why she was so upset. And so the girls in the state where he's in college, and all the girls the girls in the college were all going, oh, he sexually harassed her, he sexually molested her. And
she said that
she basically, she kind of just acted, and then they created. Oh, did he hurt you? Did he touch you? Did he? And she started crying. She never answered that. And then they created the whole scenario, and then she went along with it, and then he ended up getting kicked out of school.
Really?
Yeah.
For that?
Yeah.
Oh my God!
Yeah,
that's another one. Like when it gets to that territory,
oh,
they start throwing around
psycho. It's very scary.
But when they start throwing around, I mean, I've never. But just watching that from the outside, when that happens.
Crazy.
When they start throwing around the sexual abuse terms, I mean, there's no
kick
getting
the
out of
out.
That ever.
Right, and
nope,
you
kick
you,
him out.
You
I'm
gotta,
done.
Right, yeah. But then you kick him out, and then she goes, "He raped me."
Yeah, that's
record,
a bad.
Bitch. Thank you, Apple, for the record button. Hit that red
that's
button.
Why the Kobe. I mean, I don't know what happened in the Kobe thing, but I mean,
yeah.
That was like I don't know what happened.
Right, but you know
I
what
always,
they thought happened.
And in my mind, I'll always think he probably raped her. I mean, I don't. And maybe he didn't. Maybe she was just weird and didn't want to.
Could have been. Could have been. A payday. Could have been a payday.
Karma.
Could have been a payday. Tom, thank you so much for coming out, brother.
Thank you.
And I hope you had a good time, man. We had a great time. It was good seeing you again, man.
Same.
And we're going to see each other more on the circuit. I didn't know. Congratulations on law school, too.
Yeah, it's been very hard. And please watch. I have a movie on Hulu right now.
What
please
movie watch is that?
It's called Adventures in Comedy.
Okay.
I wrote it, directed it, star in it.
Nice.
Jim Gaffigan's in it.
Really? I'm going to check it out. Garoppolo. I'm going to check it out today, in fact. So.
Yeah, it's good. It's funny.
Okay.
It's really funny. It's
is
a
it on Netflix still? Or no?
No. It's on everything except Netflix.
Okay.
They were going to try and get it on Netflix after Hulu.
Is it on iTunes?
Yeah.
It is on
Amazon.
What is it called on?
It's called Adventures in Comedy.
Okay. Give me your Twitter real quick, too.
At Tom McCaffrey.
All right. It's up on now. We're going to push up. We got the cameras going so you can see if you don't get it now. Spell it for them so they can get it.
TOMMCCAFF. R-E-Y.
Tom McCaffrey. Check him out. Funny, funny dude. Funny, funny, funny dude. Check out his movie. Shout out to Mara. Bitch, come home. Everybody tweet Mara. Bitch, come home. you can also check her out on everybody's link. Follow everybody's link on beigephillip.com. It's going down. Harry, talk to me.
You could go to my website, ihatecomedy.com. That's where all my stuff is. And you could find me at Twitter or Instagram. Just at Harry Terjanian.
Andre, talk to me.
Yo, follow me on Instagram and Twitter, Andre_D. Thompson. Hit me up.
Yeah, and everything, you can find me at Dante Nero, DanteNero. Follow me on Twitter. Rate and review us on iTunes. Really important. Also, if you need a one-on-one consultation, hit me at SaveMeDante@gmail.com. Hit me with an email. I'll hit you back. Tell you the details of how you can get me to talk to you directly and so you can manage your bitch.
Nice.
GYBB, get your balls back. BABB, be a better bitch. WWDD, what would Dante do? The sexual revolution is being podcasted. Yo, I love y'all, Square Pimp Brigade. Don't forget to rate and review us. Really important. We are out. Love y'all. Peace.